How's it going, everyone? Frankie was here, and we're back into Dark Souls. I believe this is episode 17. You have to look back, but anyway, we have entered Olasiel Township, and invasions are definitely a thing that can happen here. So we're gonna try to get through this area as fast as possible, hopefully with as less deaths as possible to dark magic jerk holes. That meaning the enemies, not the players. Players who use dark magic, it's okay. I mean, they want to be a loser. You know, whatever. I don't want to judge him. I didn't mean not mean to kick there. So, these beginning ones, they hit a high amount of damage to you, so just try to block them. If you don't have a great shield, you might want to just dodge their attacks because it will drain a ton of your stamina. Let's keep moving forward. There we go. They have a little bit of health. Don't like these guys on New Game Plus and forward. They start hitting pretty hard. These are the main enemies in this area, though. Dark magic. They'll shoot them at like a bead at you. Now, dark magic does, I believe, 50% physical and 50% magic damage, which is what makes our shield so very powerful. The fact that we resist 50% magic and 100% physical with our high amount of stability. There's an enemy over here who will try to just ambush you. Like a complete and total jerk. Let me make 100% sure. Yes, we are recording. Good. So, the cool little things you can do around here. If you are human and you move forward through here, you will be invaded by an NPC. That is inevitable. That will happen. So, we're going to go ahead and kill off Marvelous Chester and not let him use his sniper crossbow bow trickery. Okay, he didn't drop anything. There's some cool little items you can actually get in the zone. So I'm going to explore a little bit. Let's see. If I can remember where they were at. Because you can actually start to get items which are little carvings you can drop on the ground. You can use them as many times as you want. And when you drop them, I believe this is one of them. This is not a zone you can open up. I guess I've dropped down there. But when you use them, your character will drop them on the ground. Not like you can drop as many as you want. It's kind of like drinking your Estus, but you have an infinite amount. And when you use it, a voice will go over and say something. Like if you use the I'm sorry carving, it will say, I'm sorry. And it's just altogether a really funny item to use. So if you like kill someone in a really embarrassing way, or if they just fall off a cliff, you can just start like throwing I'm sorry or I'm sorry over and over again, or thank yous if they actually help you out. So where in the world was I supposed to go? I believe I'll follow this little phantom who just walked over here. So I'm pretty sure there was an illusionary wall. Okay, I heard a magic caster. What we're gonna do is we're gonna keep her shield up. Do not get hit by that, because remember, we're blocking a ton of the damage there, and it still hurts a nice chunk of her health, especially if you get up to, like, New Game Plus. You do not want to get hit by them. Now, they have different attacks. That's just, like, the normal straightforward. They also have an attack which is kind of like a bead. I think it's called Dark Bead, where they will fire multiple different, like, it's kind of like a shotgun of attacks. Now, that's a normal chest because of the way it's closed. There's Dark Orb. I'll go over it just to show you guys the disgusting magic. But as it says there, Giants of Fire, a giant Dark Orb. Yeah, it does a high amount of damage. Dark magic just does an insanely high amount of damage in the game. But if, as long as your opponent isn't lagging, like some people will just lag like mad and they'll hit you with dark magic in PvP and it's annoying. But it's generally easy to dodge them, so that's kind of like the reasoning for being so strong. You can dodge them. There's the I'm sorry carving. We got it from killing that enemy. And I'll show you what it does real quick. Yep, that's about it. That's like one of the only ways to talk to people in Dark Souls, is dropping carving stones, saying, I'm sorry, thank you, or stuff like that. Let's go ahead and try to figure out the way out of here again. I believe we just have to go this way. I believe, but hey. Okay. Let's not forget about what's behind us though. So I'm gonna clear what's behind us first. Okay, he's trying to sneak up on us, so let's not let him do that. Anyway, what I was gonna say was, again, the chain on this enemy, you could tell it was a mimic. So, we kill the mimic. And we got a very good carving, so now we drop it and it will say, as its name is... You can drop that if like a host stops attacking you after you're trying to tell him not to. You know, just trying to tell him, hey, I'm friendly, and then, you know. Anyway, that was the one who's trying to sneak behind. You'll notice we have dark magic being casted at us. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to back up and then heal up over here. Thinking back now, I don't know why I kindled the bonfire so much. This part isn't the difficult part. Later on is when you fight against the boss Manus. Anyway, though. You also gotta be careful because these guys do have like a kind of a grab-ish like attack, and I believe they have a knockback. But their shotgun attack, I believe, is very fast, where it will just do massive amounts of damage to you. This guy's a glowing head. These guys have a chance to drop the bloated head, actually. It looks kind of funny, doesn't weigh much if I remember right. It's just an item you can use if you want to be like funny. Remember, this is Dark Souls. Always expect to be ambushed, especially from above. Which would be right over here. Go on your butt. There we go. Rubbish. Yeah, you'd normally pick that up and he would walk behind you and just hit you for a lot of your health. What I'm going to try to do here is walk forward and then run back, see if we didn't aggro any of them. We did not, so let's go ahead and do this again. Walk forward, walk back. We definitely did aggro some of them. Sorry about the camera angle. There we go. I'm going to see if I can't... okay, we have a dark magic user casting from up there. As you can see, that damage it did. If we were like mid-swing trying to attack them, it would do even more, if I remember right. Let's not lock on at all. I don't remember what that attack is. Okay, I think that's the Poison Toxic Cloud. Pretty sure it's Poison Toxic. One of these two. Let's back away because we do have Dark Magic cast at us, and we do not want to get hit while we're swinging or while we can't be blocking. Let's go for a one hit and a two hit. There we go. So both physical dealers are gone. We have another physical dealer running over here. Let's dodge that. Moving closer, because we only have one caster hitting us, or trying to attack us, who is able to actually hit us from where he's sitting at, we'll go ahead and kill the enemy where he was standing. Let's go ahead and roll away. I believe we just got a humanity there. You saw the black come to us. Unless we have to do 1-2 swing, and let's heal up, because we are low enough on health to warrant healing up. Now pick this item up real quick. Soul of a Hero. That's pretty good. I don't think we've gotten one of those yet, so let's take it off our hotbar. Hey, enemies, come on over here. I'm friendly. Well, I would be friendly, but they're complete jerks, so I'm not friendly to them. Large Titanite Shard. Strange, you think with how much damage these guys do and how much health they have that you would get something better than a large Titanite Shard? I mean, how much health they have? They don't have much health, but for how much damage they deal, you'd think they would give you something better than just that. Let's make our way back up here. I believe this is another location where they will try to ambush you at. It's forward, up ahead. I did not mean to roll there, and as such, I got hit. We do a nice amount of backstab damage here. I like that. So we can either go that way, or which does lead to a secret Illusionary wall, if I remember right. Yeah, there is an illusionary wall ahead, but I don't believe it's on this area. I believe it's over there somewhere. So the thing about some illusionary walls is you can actually use the skull lantern, if I remember right. Probably, yeah, I think I fat roll now. There we go. And it's shown. So there we go. Let's put back on our shield though. And here we go. So we now have a chest over here. Because of the way the chain is, we know it's safe. And that gives us a red titanite chunk. Meh, it's used to upgrade a weapon from fire plus 5 to 6, I believe, in chaos. Just chaos. We're gonna jump into here. Fend off this little guy over here. Now remember, the way the chain is faced means if it's a mimic or not. Let's go ahead and kill this mimic. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, just like back in Anor Londo. Takes 4 swings to kill. I remember, it did take 4 swings to kill, right? So that was the, what was that, the crest key or something? I'm trying to remember what we use that for. I think we use that to open up a door for an NPC we have to talk to later on. So, we can drop down this way. And drop down this way. Wasn't there an item up here? Nah, I don't care. We're not trying to collect every single item in the game. If we were, I would, this would be a very long playthrough. I've done that before. It took me like 20 hours or so to make sure I got every single item and then every Covenant rank. Minus the Gravelord Covenant, because that thing's like almost impossible to rank up. So, looky where we are now. We're back all the way at the beginning. So, now that we're back all the way at the beginning, we can go through this shortcut to make our way down. And if we die now, we can easily go down here really quickly. Just be careful. The elevators are very dangerous in Dark Souls. You have a high chance of falling off them to your death. So, Magicaster. Physical guy up there, and there's a physical guy over here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna run for cover instantly. Because of our high amount of armor and poise, we don't get knocked back from that. I believe that's the poison cloud again. Yes, let's not get poisoned. I've actually never seen them use the poison cloud attack in my entire life. So it's pretty interesting to see them actually use that. So he's laughing, so we're gonna go in for a swing. And put her shield up instantly. And there we go. We're gonna go for the second swing. Now I believe there is an item on this side. No, don't go down there. There we go. Right here. I'm glad I remember some of this stuff. It helps us out a bit. So let's keep moving forward. Now this guy, this friendly little guy. He's not a boss. I believe he does respawn, and he hits like a truck. He's a decently like put together enemy. I would love if they had more enemies like him. It would make this DLC at least difficult. Because like, look at that. We get hit by that because we got stupid and overconfident. He's gonna hit us with that? No? Okay. So I believe you have to use like a certain type of attack so you don't get knocked back by every time you hit him. It's a bit annoying to be honest, but let's two-hand our weapon and stagger him to death. There we go. That's why I like this weapon. When you decide you want to stop giving them a try, or you want to not give them any more of a chance, just, you know, two-hand your weapon and boom. So we're going to activate this. Keep your shield up, or keep your, you know, stay back if you're a caster, because it will bring a little gift. This butthole right here. So we're going to kill him in one single hit. Normally he might knock you down. I've never died to him before, but still. And here is the last bonfire of the DLC. This is the one you're going to be resting at throughout the next area. So, what I mean by that is this is the last bonfire that you actually activate. Shortcut to the final boss. The final DLC needed boss. You don't have to kill Calamite. The giant dragon. We will be killing Calamite, the gigantic dragon, though. Do not worry. I love that fight. Even if I die on that fight, it is. I just love that fight. So I believe in the next episode we'll do Calamite and stuff. We'll get to get him to spawn, then we have to talk to a certain NPC who will help us actually fight him. Let's go and level up our health a bit more. And we're good there. Let's take off our hood because we're going to want to put on the skull lantern. The reason for that is this area is pretty dang dark. See, without the skull lantern. With the skull lantern. Well, heck, we probably don't need it. Let's take it. Let's put back on our hood. There we go. I noticed a little bit of a frame rate drop right back there. I hope it didn't happen in the video. There we go. We had to use a power attack. That way we would swing down. So, there's a caster to the left along with two physical attacking guys. I'll go ahead and show you in case you need to go over here to pick up the item. Oh, we didn't kill him with a single. Okay, yeah, it's because we had counter damage to the last one. Due to the fact he was already trying to attack us. Let's go ahead and go in for the magic caster here. Go for a swing. I cannot believe I missed like all of those. Anyway, the thing you want to get used to. God, frame rate drop. Let me see if everything's okay. I'm wondering what happened, why that frame rate drop happened. Yeah, there's the dark magic I was talking about previously, the dark bead. Fires excessive dark beads. I believe this was the one that shoots like eight of them or something like that, and each one does damage. It does a lot of damage if you're up close to an enemy. This frame rate drop, this is horrible. Good lord. Anyway, we kindled our bonfire, so that way we have 20 Estus. I'm very sorry about this frame rate drop. I don't know what I can do to fix it. It's just here. These are actually humanity enemies. You may notice they look just like the humanity little icon, and that's because, you know, they are humanity. I think it's called solid humanity or something. But if you kill these guys, they have a very, very high chance. The reason I'm using humanity is to get up to 10, so that way I can farm these guys for a bit. Not farm them, but just kill them real quick. They hit decently hard. Let's just not lock on at all. If I can unlock. There we go. Now they don't hit very hard, but they do drop humanity at a high rate. So we want to kill them whenever we find them. They're like kind of like the goodie bags of the DLC. You know, you get to kill them, you get humanity, which has not dropped yet. I normally get like four. And I've not seen a single humanity drop. So right now I just feel very, very wasteful and very sad. And that was dark magic right to the face. We didn't even notice. Piece of crap. Let's keep moving down. And hopefully not get hit in the back by it. We can't reach that guy yet. We'll have to go all the way across here to finally reach him. But there's an item behind here. Twin humanities. Let's just act like that drop from the humanity enemies. And that way I can be happy and not be sad. So we have to go forward. I believe on the left. Okay, buddy, I get the picture. You're a jerk. You don't gotta tell me. Anyway, as I was saying. Yeah, you laugh over there. You'll see who's laughing soon. We go this way. Heal up. That bum. And this is a white titanite? Yeah, white titanite slab. Which is nah. I think we actually have to go back. I'm wanting to show you where we can find good old little Sif. I'm wondering, wait, Sif? Yeah, Sif. Little puppy Sif. Sif, the great wolf we killed to make our shield. Which I regret doing, but hey, we had to do it to get our shield made, and the shield has been so helpful to us. Let's just go ahead and take out this bomb, though. Yeah, that was the dark bead, and I was blocking that. If I was not, I'm pretty sure I would be dead. But Sif the wolf is actually Artorias, the guy we fought before. It's his wolf. The reason he was protecting his master's grave, I believe, is that was actually Artorias' grave. This is an illusionary wall. It would drop us down here. is, as you can see, the cat in the forest, who's the leader of the Cat Covenant, or actually one who looks like it, because we can only speculate, is protecting the wolf. And the cat doesn't like it when you go near Artorias' grave. But basically, Artorias was. Or not Artorias. Sif was protecting his master's grave and keeping any travelers away from getting the ring, the Covenant of Artorias. Because Artorias went into the Abyss, the area basically we're into now, who the last, or one of the bosses of this area is, Manus of the Abyss, hails from, to kind of fight the Abyss. And he went insane and became corrupted by the Abyss. Now, it would be very hard to tell, but, well, as this person says right here, I'll go and rate that up. Maybe more people will look at it. But, Little Wolf Sif just didn't want anyone else to become corrupted. So that's why he was protecting the grave. If you go here and you meet Sif first, this is him back in the past, because we are in the past right now. If you go and you meet little baby Sif here, then you fight him later in the future. Sif will actually go up to you and just look at you very sadly when he jumps on you. And then howl kind of sadly. The fact that he has to fight you, but he doesn't want anyone else to become corrupted by the Abyss like his master was. It's a really sad story, and that's why I really feel bad every time I kill Sif. But as you can see now, you're okay, buddy. And there goes Sif. It's the cleansing great shield. It's a little bit like our shield, at least it looks a little bit like our shield. Man, now I'm sad every time I do that. But it has like almost 80% of all resistances minus lightning. It weighs less than our shield, you know, it's a decent shield. But it's not really good because it doesn't have 100% chance to block physical, which is mainly what you use shields for. It could be good for magic, but not many enemies use solely magic attacks. The most time you can just roll to avoid a magical attack. When a physical attack, you have to block a lot of the time. Let's go ahead and activate this elevator. I never really use it, but we can just walk out here now once we get up. And you might notice where we're at again. We're right back nearby where we fought Artorias at. So Little Wolf Sif was underneath here, guarded by Artorias's, or as we believe to be Artorias' shield. Because in Dark Souls, they don't necessarily tell you everything. And I'm pretty sure that Artorias is actually left-handed. And when we fight him, his left hand is kind of deformed and broken. So we basically fight Artorias without his sword hand in full order and him using his shield hand as to hold his sword. So if you thought Artorias was a difficult boss, just realize the fact that he's not even using his most powerful hand. Let's go ahead and run past the humanities if we can. I don't remember where I'm going. I'm going completely the wrong way. What we have to do is we have to go forward and then look to the right. If I am correct in that. No, I believe because we use the shortcut, we have to go all the way around again. Yeah, I'll tell you what, because I'm probably going to waste more time looking around for where the right way is to go, I'm going to quickly use a homeward bone. And we'll make our way to Menace. Who, if I end up dying, hey, that's fine. But Menace is not really a boss who I ever have problems with. Just gonna give you that up ahead of time. I might not die to him, so you might not get any entertaining deaths here. So we're gonna run on by, and we're gonna run down here and make our way back to where we found the white Titanite slab, I believe it was. There we go. Just follow the little lights. The enemies did respawn, but we don't really have to focus on them. I know we have a melee attacker, or one of the melee crazy guys behind us, but we don't really have to care about him. We're just gonna keep running forward, and I'm gonna keep my shield up. as we run past the jerk over here. There we go. So he's laughing. Okay. Usually they'll laugh if, when they laugh, you can tell you have like a few seconds of you're able to do whatever you want because they're too busy laughing and mocking you like a jerk. So we have ourselves our gold pine resin down, our green blossom as well. We're going to be using both of these in the boss fight. Manus is a pretty heavy combo-like boss. If I have the Sif summoning sign inside the boss room, I'm going to use it. I believe you can summon Sif for this boss fight. Now you don't have to use the Covenant of Artorias, thankfully, to not die in this abyss. There we go. Manus brought us to him. We didn't like, you know, get ourselves grabbed on purpose. He grabbed us, so he brought this upon himself. Remember that, Manus, when I'm kicking your butt. The strengths of this boss: high physical damage, very high magical resistance, has a lot of combos that you have to be careful to avoid, and just does a lot of damage. Now, I probably should have done this before we enter the boss fight. Get her shield up. His weaknesses: he has only physical attack and very slight amounts of magic attacks, which can be because they are dark magic, which means they... Here's a combo. Now, because we have our amazing shield, we can block that. Now, he does use dark magic, but along with using dark magic being like, you know, a very high hitting damaging ability, we can block dark magic, a lot of it. Due to the fact that dark magic is half physical, half magic, we don't take that much damage from it. Go ahead and block that. Let's go in for a swing again. Now we miss. Let's let him do a swipe. He's gonna hit the ground. I'm gonna want to go in for a heal again. Gonna go for a heal after that. There we go. Now he'll start using dark magic pretty soon. He's gonna go for a second swing. That's when we'll hit. And we'll get her shield back up when we can. He's gonna go for his combo. And jump attack. Now as long as you memorize his little combos, he's not that difficult of a boss. I don't know how... Okay, we got hit in the combo. Now I just don't... Oh, here we go. We can summon Sif. I just don't know why people call this one of the more difficult bosses in Dark Souls. Because by this point in the game, you have a great shield. You can have a great shield, you can have a lot of, you know, just survivability, and you can take them on easily. I think the more difficult bosses in the game are stuff like Capra Demon, Ceaseless Discharge without using the little one-hit move you can use on him, which I will not be using in this playthrough because I think it's kind of cheap and ruins the fun of the boss fight. But, okay, as you can see, he's going to start casting that magic stuff on us. We can just roll. It doesn't deal much damage to us because we do have a lot of physical resist again. And we're going to keep swinging on him. It's just slow and steady. We've used three Estus so far. He's going to swipe, then he's going to do a jump attack. We can block it. We can run in, get a hit in. And then let our stamina regenerate slightly and then block before he lands. Just... I never really understood how this boss was known as such a difficult boss fight. That's a dark beat attack. You're going to want to block that. Or if you don't have a lot of, you know, don't have a big shield on and you don't dodge attacks, which we don't dodge attacks anymore. You just want to roll out of the way if you don't have a shield and you're not wearing heavy armor. Because it will kill you. That move will kill you. I will give the boss that one thing. That move is very dangerous. Gonna go for his combo, attack, and then jump attack. And I like that little we get knocked back type thing while we're blocking. There's his hand attack, which he hardly ever uses, and it's very weak. Dark magic again, it's meh. Remember, we don't have too many points in health. I believe most people are higher level when they fight Manus. One of my friends told me this is actually the last boss he fights on his character before he beats the game. And I'm like, really? This boss is easier than, like, Sif, in my opinion. He's easier than Sif, he's easier than Bed of Chaos. Not Four Kings. Four Kings you just can brain dead and fight against. Get another hit in. Let's let him hit us with that, just to show you the damage there. Also, our stamina was kind of low. Let's heal up. So, that was the end of Manus, Father of the Abyss. It's, I'm sorry about the kind of sad fight, just, it's not that big of a boss fight. And here we have Dusk, who's going to keep being very sad, I believe. Let's talk to her one more time. Yeah, she's very sad right now. I believe she got taken by Manus. Where's her bonfire? There it is. So that was the last actual kind of like you need to beat him by boss that counts as beating the DLC in a way. It just, the next boss you have to actually go around and figure out ways to kind of unlock him. Let's grow up vitality twice and then pop a point of strength, why not? Now our health is 1459, and our damage is 447. Do we have anything to upgrade our weapon? No, we do not. So what will we do next? What we'll do next is I'm gonna have to end this episode here. But honestly, I'm not even using pyromancy at all. Huh. I'll go ahead and put flash sweat down here. That gives you a lot of fire resist. And I'll put Fire Orb down, that way I just have a pyromancy I actually might use if somebody invades me and they're using pyromancies. So what we'll do in the next one is we're going to figure out how to fight Calamite. I already know how to fight him, but I'll show you guys how to get to Calamite, how to fight him. And we'll try to take on Calamite and hopefully not die. So far we're pretty good with bosses after we killed... Actually, after we killed, let's see, not Iron Golem, but after we killed Capra? Have we had a death to a boss after Capra? I'm not sure if we got a death to a boss after we killed Capra. So, let's hope we can keep this up. Again, I'm using my weapon and my shield, so I have my two things I'm very used to using. That's probably why I haven't died. So if you fight against these bosses and you end up dying, just keep trying. Just remember, keep your shield up. When you swing, hold down the blocking button already, so the second that you finish swinging your weapon, you have your shield up. Manage your stamina. Use Green Blossom. Don't do what I did and go into the boss room, then buff up. Buff up right before you get to the boss room. And remember to summon people and have fun. Alright, until next time, guys, have a good one.